Hello students, I am Jnaneshwara TN. Today I would like to discuss the general characteristics of Puritan age. Puritan age. The Renaissance movement was accompanied by a moral awakening in England during the 16th century. It advocated the purification of religious practices. Those who were pure in thought, action, conduct, and behavior were called to be Puritans. They gave more importance to the Holy Scripture, the Bible, as an authority in matters of religious practices and individual conduct. Since Puritans became dominant force in England during this period is called Puritan Age. The great genius John Milton was the staunch follower of Puritanism, and he was the most representative poet of the age. Therefore, this period is also called as the Age of Milton. Now, we shall discuss the general characteristics of Puritan age. They are historical perspective, civil war, and the Puritan movement. Historical perspective. After the death of Queen Elizabeth in 1603, James I became the King of England. A group of clergy met him and presented a petition in which he was asked to redress various abuses found in the Church of England. The king feared that the granting of more rights to Puritans would be dangerous to him. He followed anti-Puritan policy. His son Charles I succeeded to the throne in 1625. He proved to be a dictator and dissolved the parliament. Puritans beheaded Charles I and tried to establish a government, something like a democracy. Meanwhile, Oliver Cromwell established Commonwealth government. There was political instability during those turbulent years. The rule of Cromwell did not last long. He died in the year 1660, which paved way for restoration of monarchy. Thus, the Puritan age witnessed the turbulent events in political and religious field. It proved to be an age of transition as many changes took place within a short span of time. Civil war. The entire period of Puritan age was dominated by civil war. The people of England were divided into two groups, one loyal to the king and the other opposed him. The crisis began when King James I came to throne in 1603. He gave importance to royal throne as the divine right, ignoring the powers of parliament. The Puritans started a widespread movement for religious and constitutional reforms. There was a war between King's loyalists and Puritans from 1642 to 1649. At last, King Charles I succeeded James I but was executed. There was an establishment of Commonwealth government under the dynamic leadership of Oliver Cromwell. Thus, the crises and hostilities between two groups disturbed the life of English people. Unlike Elizabethan age, Puritan age was marked by internal conflicts which caused chaos and confusion in English society. The Puritan movement. The Renaissance had exercised great influence on Elizabethan literature, which was essentially pagan and sensuous. It did not give much importance to moral nature of man. Therefore, Puritanism arose as a historical necessity. According to W.J. Long, I quote, "The Puritan movement may be regarded as a second and the greatest renaissance, a rebirth of the moral nature of man following the intellectual awakening in the 15th century, unquote. Puritanism had two prime goals, purity of conduct and personal liberty. Puritans were not a religious sect. It was a national movement which brought together people of various sects to raise a voice of protest against the despotism found in the church and the state. Dear students, let us recall what we have learnt in this session. After the death of Queen Elizabeth in 1603, James I became the King of England. A group of clergy met him and presented a petition in which he was asked to redress various abuses found in the Church of England. The king feared that the granting of more rights to Puritans would be dangerous to him. He followed anti-Puritan policy. His son Charles I succeeded to the throne in 1625. He proved to be a dictator and dissolved the parliament. Puritans beheaded Charles I and tried to establish a government, something like a democracy. Meanwhile, Oliver Cromwell established Commonwealth government. There was political instability during those turbulent years. The rule of Cromwell did not last long. He died in the year 1660, which paved way for restoration of monarchy. King James I came to throne in 1603. He gave importance to royal throne, ignoring the powers of parliament. The Puritans started a widespread movement for religious and constitutional reforms. There was a war between King's loyalists and Puritans from 1642 to 1649. This is the Civil War. The Renaissance had exercised great influence on Elizabethan literature, which was essentially pagan and sensuous. It did not give much importance to moral nature of man. Therefore, Puritanism arose as a historical necessity. The Puritan movement may be regarded as a second Renaissance. Puritanism had two prime goals, purity of conduct and personal liberty. It was a national movement which brought together people of various sects to raise a voice of protest against the despotism found in the church and the state. This is the list of references. In the next session, we shall discuss the literary characteristics of Puritan age. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.